Welcome back to the Accessible Art History YouTube channel. This week, I'm going to be starting a new three-part series on the Italian Renaissance. This period of art history is one of the most popular because it represents a great shift in both thought and creativity. Starting at the beginning of the 15th century, artists started experimenting with what art could be. So to learn more about the early Renaissance, then keep on watching. The early Renaissance is often referred to as the Quattrocento period. It derives from Italian words for the 15th century. At this time, artists and philosophers started to re-examine the classical past for inspiration. They also started to believe in a more people-centered mindset. Called humanism, it put emphasis on the individual and the relationship with the world. As a byproduct, people started to wonder if the church was as needed as it had been for a relationship with God. It was still an important and powerful institution, but this was the beginning of the power slip. Another major change was patronage. For centuries, it was only the wealthy that could afford art, primarily royalty, nobles, and the church. But at this point in history, a middle class began to develop. For example, in Florence, the epicenter for the Renaissance, merchants became quite wealthy from the trade of wool. Eventually, they also became quite powerful, like the Medici family, who would go on to rule the city. Money was spent on beautifying the town and enriching cultural heritage. In order to illustrate these major changes, let's dive into three magnificent examples. For many art historians, Lorenzo Ghiberti and his bronze doors are one of the first works of the Renaissance. The artist won the commission in 1401 at the age of only 21. The Cloth Guild of Florence sponsored a contest to redecorate the doors of the city's baptistry. Although it took him over 2 decades to complete, it was well worth the wait. One set of doors contains 28 biblical scenes, 20 from Christ's life, and 8 featuring the saints. Another set of doors feature 10 stories from the Old Testament. These works are considered to be so beautiful that even the great Michelangelo was taken aback. He dubbed them the Gates of Paradise. These doors represent the tenets of the early Renaissance for a few reasons. The first is the use of three-dimensionality, especially through the stacking of figures. Ghiberti manipulated the material to create elaborate folds in the cloth, resembling the Roman togas of old. Finally, the figures interact with each other. This creates a dynamic storytelling effect not present in art for centuries. With the rise of patronage, wealthy citizens would commission artists to decorate their tombs so they would be remembered for eternity. One of these works is the Holy Trinity by Masaccio. It was painted between 1426 and 28. In this work, there are life-size figures of God, Christ on the cross, the Virgin Mary, Saint John, and the two donors. By making the figure so large, Masaccio was eliminating the barrier between the human and the divine. This piece was one of the first to use a vanishing point for the creation of perspective. All the lines converge downwards toward the center of the ledge. This causes the viewer to look up at Christ. It's a clever painting technique that creates a sense of three-dimensionality. Masaccio also worked to bring the classical past into his work. The architectural details not only provide another element of depth, but they're reminiscent of the great Roman basilicas of the past. Another way that classical inspiration came into the early Renaissance was in the form of the dome of the Florence Cathedral. It was designed by a goldsmith named Brunelleschi. He saw the architecture of the previous medieval period as ugly and heavy. This was because the walls were held up with flying buttresses. So Brunelleschi looked to the Pantheon in Rome for inspiration. It took him a decade, but it was finally unveiled in 1426. Brunelleschi's innovative solution was to build two domes nestled inside each other. He used interior ribbing and hoops to help distribute the weight more evenly, taking the place of flying buttresses. In addition, he ordered that brick be used instead of stone. This was much lighter, taking off more strain from the ribbing and hoops. To this day, it's considered an engineering marvel. It was something that hadn't been tried before, but Brunelleschi had the guts to do it. The early Renaissance was a period of tremendous growth in human thought and expression. This would continue into the High Renaissance, so keep an eye out for that video coming soon.